If you want our lowest prices on our best selection of new and used vehicles, then visit the Bill Hood family of dealerships, Louisiana's low price leader, or click hoodauto.com. Visit Bill Hood Ford Lincoln in Hammond, Bill Hood Nissan, Mazda, and Hyundai on the import corner in Hammond, Bill Hood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Amite, Bill Hood Chevrolet in Covington, plus our two new stores, Bill Hood Premium Pre-Owned in Hammond and Bill Hood Pre-Owned Outlet in Ponchatoula. Click hoodauto.com.
Robbie Miller loves Tanchpo Parish. Whether you have lived here your whole life or just moved here, Robbie is committed to you. It's time for Tanchpo to play the next play. Please vote October 24th, Robbie Miller for our parish president. New innovative leadership for the future of Tanchpo Parish. Injured on the field, hurt on the job, been in a car accident? The doctors at Anton's Chiropractic Care will help you get back to pre-injury performance level. With treatments including chiropractic adjustments, physical therapy, and massage therapy, you will quickly begin seeing results. Anton's even schedules Saturday appointments to ensure that your treatment will not interfere with your schedule. So give them a call at 985-542-1640 to schedule your appointment or stop by their downtown location in Hammond across from the Columbia Theater. That's Anton's Chiropractic Care for all your chiropractic needs.
Dixie RV Superstore is your number one source for the largest selection of new and pre-owned RVs. You're sure to find the RV of your dreams with 68 acres of motorhomes, travel trailers, fifth wheels, and toy haulers. We also have an RV collision center and 56 service bays to better serve you. Dixie RV, located off I-12 exit 35 in Hammond. Check out DixieRV.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Bailey. I'm running for state representative here in District 73. As a small business owner of 16 years, I know the strains of an oversized government. I also know the need for fiscal responsibility. I plan to represent you with honesty and integrity. I also plan to create an economic development plan for our region. I want to ask for your vote on October 24th, and I want to thank you in advance from my family to yours.
For all of your insurance needs, call State Farm agent Robbie Lee. Whether you own a house, a condominium, or live in rental property, State Farm has a policy that is right for you. We offer a wide variety of life insurance, health and disability insurance, as well as business insurance.
Hi, I'm Robbie Lee. For all your insurance needs, stop by 227 Northwest Central Avenue in Amite. We'll take care of you.
Robbie Lee and his friendly staff will gladly assist you. Call them today at 985-748-9000. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
When you need a pharmacy, Drive-In Drugstore has just what the doctor ordered. Located at 228 South 1st Street in Amite, Drive-In Drugstore is ready to give you the personal attention and customer service you deserve. We fill all of your prescription needs promptly and carefully, and we're happy to answer questions or concerns you may have about a particular medication. We also stock an extensive selection of over-the-counter medications, vitamins, and herbal supplements for your health and well-being. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. until 6 p.m., and on Saturdays from 8 to 2. We accept most prescription insurance plans and Medicare drug discount programs. Drive-In Drugstore in Amite.
When you want it done right the first time, take it to Jim's Paint and Body Shop. With over 30 years of automotive body repair and painting experience, Jim's works on all makes and models. Jim's is family-owned and operated. All work is guaranteed, estimates are free, and all insurance claims are welcome. Go by 55461 East Durbin Road in Independence or give them a call at 878-2329. That's Jim's Paint and Body Shop. We do it right the first time.
Come to Buddy's Home Furnishings at 706 West Oak Street in Amite for all your home furnishing needs, including electronics, home furniture, appliances, computers, and more. Buddy's has competitive prices, big names like Ashley, LG, Samsung, Kenmore, and many more. We offer rent-to-own or 2-4 or 6 months same as cash with no credit checks, and same-day delivery is available. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you. Own it faster for less at Buddy's Home Furnishings in Amite and Hammond.
Welcome to WSTY's Game of the Week here in Loranger, Louisiana, Rusty Chambers Field in front of a full moon and a packed house. And what would have been a big District 7-3A matchup between Loranger and Amite is now just a off-district rivalry as they will match up here in Loranger. Amite will be receiving the opening kickoff. Carson Reed to boot it away. Directional kick on the ground, goes out of bounds at about the 34-yard line. So two teams with storied traditions in the last 10 years. Amite comes into the game 2-1, and Loranger comes in 1-2 after a much anticipated rematch with Ponchatoula after the jamboree last year. Loranger played well, but then had a field goal block, returned for a touchdown. It was all Ponchatoula after that. So both teams coming in. Amite coming off a big, hard-fought battle, though, with Kentwood, Rusty.
You're right, and Loranger's going to have to build off of what they did last week against Ponchatoula to come in here and face a tough Amite Warrior team. Like you said, it played well against Kentwood at home. So we're here looking for a big, big game here tonight in Loranger.
Now, Loranger coming in here as they're moving up in classification, no longer in 3A. They're in District 8-4A, along with Lakeshore, Franklinton, Pearl River, and Salmon, a tough district. We will be seeing the Wolves against Franklinton and Salmon later on in the season. Looks like we got some problems with the clock, and we'll take a timeout. Ball resting at the 34-yard line. It will be the Warriors, led by quarterback junior Elijah Walker, looking to throw. Devontae Smith down the sideline. Pass complete, and he's to the house, and we have a quick score here. It's Warriors 6, Wolves nothing. I didn't even set our names yet.
I'm telling you, good Lord.
So Amite strikes quickly.
17 now, seconds off the clock.
Well, you know, I was looking. Amite has scored 44 and 34 in their two wins, so they need to put points on the board and do it quickly here against Loranger. This is the WSTY Game of the Week. This is the A-team in the house. Our cameraman, Butch Lee, my partner, Rusty Barry, and I'm the big dog, Darrell Smith, bringing tonight's action. And if you got here late, you missed the opening touchdown.
Amite using that speed on the outside. Walker put a great ball deep, and they just took it to the house.
66-yard touchdown from Walker to Smith. And the Warriors will attempt the point after. Myron Doakes to kick it away. For those of us who followed us over the years, you're going to hear a lot of names on both these sides that you've heard before.
Looks like the Wolves jump offside here on this extra point.
Let's see if new coach Zebediah Powell for the Warriors decides maybe to go for two. And it looks like that's exactly what he might do as the offense coming back on the field here as they will mark it off half the distance to the goal. The Amite offense, which you didn't get a chance to talk about, led by third-year starter and All-State performer Kenner Harrell.
He's back again.
Harrell will be number 8 and got a couple of big studs back on defense. Number 5, Joshua Perry, a cornerback already committed to Alabama, and big Mark Wilson on the defensive line. So Amite's going to be another tough team this year in 3A. Wilson throws it. This time it's going to be incomplete, so they will come up short on the conversion. Your score, Amite 6, Loranger nothing. Doakes to kick it off for the Warriors. Kick headed toward Brown at the 10-yard line. He'll take it, come right up the gut. He's at the 15-20, got a little bit of a gap, but going to be hit down hard at about the 35-yard line. Brought down there by number 9, Marcus Guyton, a senior linebacker. So the Warriors will have it on offense, trailing immediately 6-0 here for the first time tonight. Warriors led by junior quarterback Evan Johnson, also in the backfield, number 1 running back Devontae Green. And what Loranger wants to come is come out here and establish the run. Amite traditionally tough against the run, so this will be the key for Loranger tonight. Johnson on the keeper, turns it upfield. He'll pick up 5. Took a hard hit, but got it out to the 40-yard line where it'll be 2nd down and 5.
I'll tell you what, dog, that defensive line for Amite is big. Of course, you talked about Wilson. You got number 63 out there, Rodney Sopcher. And then you have Ishmael Sopcher, who is a freshman, and he is a big man.
Guarantee you he's getting some looks already from some schools with his size. A little miscommunication back there. They're going to hit Johnson behind the line and drop him for a no gain. It'll bring up 3rd down and 5. Looked like he went to hand the dive off and they ran into each other, so no gain on 2nd down.
Traditionally, you see Amite in that 4-3 defense, and now you've switched to a 3-man front. It's a little different look here for the Warriors.
Well, and that's one thing. If you've seen the Warriors 20 years ago or last year, you would see like a mirror image because they every year seem like the same thing, same type of athletes, but a new coach coming in, we'll see what kind of wrinkles he throws in the mix. Big shoes to fill, though. Swing pass to the outside. Pass complete to the 40. Breaks a tackle all the way out to midfield. DJ Hookfin on the reception. And a first down at midfield for the Wolves.
Good play call there by the Wolves. Getting it outside in space, trying to make them do something. You know, you're typically not going to go deep on the Warriors. They can run. They're going to take that deep ball away. But if you get it out there and get your man a chance to make some moves, good play call.
So first down and 10, 10-13 to go here in the opening quarter. First possession for the Wolves. They've got it inside Warrior territory down to the 49-yard line. Fake the dive play. Johnson pulled it back out, but he was wrapped up immediately. No gain on the play. Second down and 10.
You know, with that three-man front, they had that outside backer slash strong safety. It looks like every time he's trying to pull off the dive, he's right there to meet him. So they're having a trouble there at that mesh point.
Well, the problem is when you got the dive, usually you want to at least have a little bit of a hole there, so they have to think about it. He's being hit in the backfield. Quarterback has to go backwards to get around the dive.
Looks like we have an official's timeout to discuss something here.
Let's see what's going on there. See the white hat with the zebras at midfield there, trying to figure out what's going on. I did not see a flag on the play. Not to say that there wasn't. Our vantage point is a little precarious tonight.
I think we have a clock issue there, and they're trying to see if they need to keep it on the field, if they're trying to see if this scoreboard is going to work. It might be skipping a little bit.
It keeps popping in and out. I don't know if it's losing time, but it does go on and off. Talking to Coach Messina on the sidelines.
It looks like they're going to keep it on the field.
So they will turn the scoreboard off, which will keep us in the dark, folks. We know right now it's 6-0. The time, 9 minutes and something, but we will be in the dark as far as the time goes.
Looks like he's setting it down there for, I think it was around 9:44 left in the quarter last time we saw it. Now, whether that was right or not, we don't know.
Looks like they still don't know what's going on. So we'll take a break and come back in just a moment. Second down and 10 for the Wolves. It will be Johnson from the shotgun. Handoff trying to get it to the outside. Flag on the play, a couple yards on the play as Hookfin on the carry.
Looks like we might have a hold outside there. They're going to wave that flag off. Looks like couldn't figure out if it was worth the call there. So looking at about 3rd and 7.
Wolves come to the line for the third down play. Trying to keep their drive alive here as they trail 6-0 early. DeAndre Brown, their big time receiver out here, man to man on the left. He's going straight up the seam, but they're going to throw it to Hookfin. Pass complete. Knocked down immediately by Devontae Smith, but he'll have a big first down for the Wolves.
I'm going to tell you what, Brown did a really good job of pulling that ball out and looking off his receiver. Everybody flowed that direction. He threw backside. Good play right there for the Wolves.
Making pretty good use of Hookfin so far, the young sophomore. First down and 10 from the 32-yard line. Johnson on the keeper, right side, bust up the middle. He'll have a first down down inside the red zone to the 19-yard line. Evan Johnson showing that quickness.
He's an athlete. He's very fast. Doing that zone read, doing a good job of reading that in, pulling it and getting up in the middle and getting those yards for the Wolves tonight.
First and 10. Johnson pulls it back out, keeps it himself, spins. We'll pick up about five.
Loranger doing a good job right now of mixing things up, running the zone read, play action.
So have some kind of equipment problem on the field. They send number 29 off. Officials timeout. Marcus Guyton in to replace him. Either had some kind of equipment problem or he probably had blood on the uniform. They had to send him out to get changed up, so it'll be second down in about four. Hook fan around right side. There's a penalty down. Ball's on the turf. Scramble for it. Looks like Loranger had the first shot at it, but let's see if he can hold on to it. They're saying they meet ball, but we have to wait and see what the penalty is. Hook fan got stripped, and this would be a big penalty against Loranger after a nice opening drive. Legal procedure against Loranger, that will be declined, and AB will have the football.
And that's one thing that Loranger can't do tonight is put the ball on the ground.
Tonight's game brought to you by Dixie RV Superstores, Bill Hood Automotive Group, Anthon's Chiropractic Clinic, Robbie Miller, candidate for parish president, Tim Bailey, candidate for state representative, District 73, Drive-In Drugstore in AB, Jim's Paint and Body Shop, State Farm Robbie Lee, and Buddy's Home Furnishings in AB and Hammond. Like to thank them for helping get the game of the week on the air. Well, the Amite offense on the field for the second time. They had it one play on their opening possession and scored a 67-yard touchdown. This will be Harrell, and he's hit immediately. Nothing there. No gain on the play. Nice job by the middle of that Wolf line.
You know, the Loranger was making the drive that they needed to answer that big play from the Warriors, putting that ball on the ground. It's a big stand here for the Loranger defense. Gonna have to step it up.
Well, you know, last week the big field goal block for a touchdown against them, and they also fumbled into the end zone and lost it. Might have been the difference against Ponchatoula, and already out here with the turnover tonight. Sure, Coach Messina isn't happy about that. Walker from the shotgun, being blitzed, steps, moves out of the way, got a man out in the flat, one blocker out front. We'll get it out to the 36-yard line. Big completion for 16 and a first down. Number 7 on the reception, Andrew Jones. And you got to like the way Walker stood back there and made the first man miss who was coming free on the blitz. Pretty poise there for the young junior. No sizes in the rosters today, but that Walker is a big kid back there. Probably stands about 6'4". Harrell up the middle. Not much there. Got back to the line of scrimmage, maybe a half yard.
So far, Loranger are forcing him to get outside with the ball. Middle of that defensive line doing a good job.
Two runs for no gain so far for Amite, and two passes complete for 80-plus yards. So far, the passing game for the Warriors has been the key. Slings it to the outside, pass in and out of the hands of Devontae Smith. Trying to set up that little bubble screen out there and just right through his hands.
Taking a look where he was going to run before he caught the ball there. Common mistake.
6 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. We have an official's timeout. Third down and 10 for the Warriors from their own 36-yard line. Here come the blitz again, picked up, makes the first man miss to the right side. Walker, a little swing pass, completed to Smith. He'll be knocked down by number 20, Jaquan Thomas, short of the first down. Be fourth and 5 in a punting situation for the Warriors. So, pretty good job there by the defensive line, stopping the run, and then they were aided by the drop pass, but the Warriors could not convert the first down, so the Wolves defense gets them off the field and will get the football back. after the turnover.
You know, Coach Young dialing up some good blitzes. Those guys are going to have to stay on the back shoulder of Walker if they're going to try to contain him in that pocket.
Doakes punts it away. Ball's going to hit and roll dead at about the 27-yard line. So Ronja will have it for the second time here in the opening quarter.
Come to Buddy's Home Furnishings at 706 West Oak Street in Amite for all your home furnishing needs, including electronics, home furniture, appliances, computers, and more. Buddy's has competitive prices, big names like Ashley, LG, Samsung, Kenmore, and many more. We offer rent-to-own or 2-4 or 6 months same as cash with no credit checks, and same-day delivery is available. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you. Own it faster for less at Buddy's Home Furnishings in Amite and Hammond.
Hi, I'm Tim Bailey, and I'm running for state representative here in District 73. I plan to enhance our vocational education system so that we have job-ready graduates. I also plan to create an economic development plan for our region. South Tangipahoa Parish is in need of a bridge of representation. I'm asking for your vote on October 24th, and allow me to be that bridge for you.
For all of your insurance needs, call State Farm agent Robbie Lee. Whether you own a house or condominium or live in rental property, State Farm has a policy that is right for you. We offer a wide variety of life insurance, health and disability insurance, as well as business insurance.
Hi, I'm Robbie Lee. For all your insurance needs, stop by 227 Northwest Central Avenue in Amite. We'll take care of you.
Robbie Lee and his friendly staff will gladly assist you. Call them today at 985-748-9000. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
First down and 10, Johnson from the shotgun. Johnson pulls it out, keeps it, runs back into traffic, and there's big number 66, Ishmael Sosper. I don't know how to say that last name. Is it
Sopshire? Yes. That name's been around Amite for a while. A lot of good players with that last name, I can tell you.
Nevertheless, call me Ishmael. Was that Moby Dick?
Yes, Moby Dick.
See, there he goes. Classic, like me.
Really classic, like Butch.
Johnson. Tripped up from behind, but breaks the tackle and will pick up the first down across the 40 out to the 43.
Wolves had a lot of success on the outside. They're doing a good job of containing their blocks up front, not allowing any penetration. He's able to get to that corner, and he's a fast guy. We've seen it many times.
But they're going to have to put something together other than him running the football. They're going to have to get somebody else involved because Amite's going to start keying on Johnson. Hands it off and hit immediately in the backfield. Nowhere to go. The brother Sopshire. Dropping for a 2-yard loss. It'll bring up second down and 12. And not much success going up the middle right now for the Wolves. Late first quarter. It's 6-0 Warriors.
Started out with a bang and has settled down here.
Johnson throws it late. It's underthrown and incomplete. It'll bring up third down and 12. And that time they did a good job keeping Johnson in the pocket and making him throw the football.
We're trying to do a little play action with that zone read, make him think he was trying to get to that corner again. He pulled up. That's a tough throw. Really is for any quarterback.
Well, especially
going the opposite
rolling
way.
Left. Yes. Yes. And I'm sure this is one of those situations, of course, every team, but especially against Amite, you want to stay out of those third and longs. Hook fin goes in motion. Johnson's going to roll right. Pressure out there by Sopcher. Hit as he threw it by number 2, Chad Jackson, and it's incomplete. And the Wolves will have to punt it away here late in the first quarter. not quite sure on that motion into it, and then he ran away from the motion, didn't let him get past him. I'm not sure what if that was correct or not. Nevertheless, fourth down for the Wolves, and they'll punt it away to the Warriors. Alias Smith and Jones back to receive. Punt headed towards Smith at the 23-yard line. Makes a nice move, gets to the outsides, cross midfield, and a big return here for the Warriors. He'll be marked out of bounds at the 35-yard line, looks like. So Amite with great field position to start their third drive. And that's two big plays already by Smith, Devontae Smith, the junior wide receiver, and obviously punt return specialist for the Warriors.
I think what they're discussing is that one of the return men from Amite on the punt raised his hand and waved it a little bit, and they wasn't the one that caught it. It was number 7. There again, no call.
Harrell, left side, big hole, cuts to the outside. He's got 10, he's got 15. He's going to be close inside the 10, inside the 5. It'll be first and goal from the 4-yard line. And, of course, we've seen Kenner Harrell over the last 2 years have tons of those runs. It's like you stop him, and all of a sudden there he goes. Big run there on first down. It'll be first and goal, Warriors.
He is a workhorse.
Harrell inside, stops short of the goal line. Cannot see if they had a flag on this side of the field because they had people running off that were not off the field when the ball was snapped. Obviously did not throw the flag. I don't know how you do not throw that flag. Second and goal.
Amy rolling in the big package there up front, rolling in some different linemen for this play.
Smith will be the lone receiver, two receivers to the outside, to the bottom of your screen. Smith along with Jones. At least getting a couple of those Wolves out of the box. Harrell on a handoff. Touchdown. So the Warriors lead at 12-0 as Harrell punches it in. So they capitalize on the big punt return. They lead it 12-0. Not a good beginning if you're a Wolf fan here in Loranger. This side of the field is quiet right now as Amite has come in and put up a couple quick touchdowns here in the opening quarter.
And I tell you, dog, this is not the same Amite team we saw last year. They're very poised, they're controlled, they're in and out of the huddle, the ball hadn't hit the ground. So they're doing a lot of good things here to be successful.
Well, to be honest, over the years, one of the big trademarks of the Amite Warriors was typical of like the Oakland Raiders. Always a lot of penalties, but so far tonight got the penalties in check as they will try the point after. This will be Dokes. Smith on the hole, kick is up. Kick is good, it's 13-0. Hopefully Butch will get a shot of that scoreboard that's out. Dokes to kick it off of the Warriors, still in the opening quarter. High, short, end-over-end kick. Fielded by Bates. Brings it to the left side. Late flag comes flying in as they return it out to the 33-yard line.
Looks like it might be a chop block.
Chop block against the Warriors. We'll back them up.
Against the Wolves.
Defense! 15-yard penalty all the way back to the 15-yard line. So you had good field position, now backed up inside your own 20. Late first quarter here, the Warriors lead by 13, and I'm sure they would like nothing better to be able to put some pressure back there and force a turnover. Wolves have to be careful here. Nice handoff to Green on the right side. Pick up a five. Devontae Green, the senior.
You know, running this offense, getting behind 13 early, they like to move the ball down the field, eat a lot of clock, so they're going to have to do some different things here if they're going to put the ball in to keep up with these Warriors.
Well, they have to be patient here. They can't panic down 13. They have to keep with their offense here, but they got to find a way to get the field position in their favor and maybe try to get some points on the board here. Johnson pulls it back out. He's going to get the outside swing pass to the outside, completed the hook fin. They'll have a first down. Nice job by Johnson. Ran it to the line of scrimmage and flicked it right before he got there. Picked up the first down.
You know, those are different things I was talking about. You know, he gets that ball outside, he might get a gain of two or three, but now they run the play, he flicks it down the field. Now you're looking at 6 to 8 yards.
Of course, that's the problem when you have an explosive quarterback is he always thinks he's one tackle away from the big play. Here comes Green. Hit out hard there by Smith at the 36-yard line. Gain of five. Nice gain there on first down. And I like to see him mixing in Green a little bit there. Can't do it all by yourself at quarterback. You get a little help from your running back. You're getting some help from Hook Finn aside from the one fumble. A little bit more of a balanced offense. Trying to keep the Warrior defense on their heels here. Green again, left side. Makes one man miss, slips and falls, and then knocked out hard at the 43, but another first down for the Wolves.
I tell you, that Loranger offensive line is doing a good job right now, getting a little push, sealing that corner, and letting his back get outside and get some yards.
Washington knocked him out of bounds late. As we said before, folks, if you just joined us, the clock is out, so we have no scoreboard, no idea of time. We just know that it's late first quarter here, keeping the time on the field. Green, right side, not much there. Gang tackle by the Warriors. Chad Jackson in there on the tackle. And also number 54, Mark Wilson down below. Second down and nine. Turner drops straight back, looking to throw. Here comes the pressure. Going to run it back up the middle and going to get dropped behind the line. We have a flag on the play, though. Looks like Amite Wisely has a spy on Johnson when he drops back to throw. If he runs toward the line, here he comes. See what the penalty is for. No flag on the play.
It's the second time tonight they've waved one off. And that's going to be
third down and 13 for the Wolves if they've gone backwards after picking up that initial first down.
Coach Messina questioning the waving off of the flag there.
Head official Mike Hommel explaining to Coach Messina the call, and both teams to the sidelines.
Dixie RV Superstore is your number one source for the largest selection of new and pre-owned RVs. You're sure to find the RV of your dreams with 68 acres of motorhomes, travel trailers, fifth wheels, and toy haulers. We also have an RV collision center and 56 service bays to better serve you. Dixie RV, located off I-12 exit 35 in Hammond. Check out DixieRV.com. D-I-X-I-E, RV, helping you.
Hi, I'm Tim Bailey. I'm running for state representative here in District 73. As a small business owner of 16 years, I know the strains of an oversized government. I also know the need for fiscal responsibility. I plan to represent you with honesty and integrity. I also plan to create an economic development plan for our region. I want to ask for your vote on October 24th, and I want to thank you in advance from my family to yours.
For all of your insurance needs, call State Farm agent Robbie Lee. Whether you own a house, a condominium, or live in rental property, State Farm has a policy that is right for you. We offer a wide variety of insurance, health and disability insurance, as well as business insurance.
Hi, I'm Robbie Lee. For all your insurance needs, stop by 227 Northwest Central Avenue in Amite. We'll take care of you.
Robbie Lee and his friendly staff will gladly assist you. Call them today at 985-748-9000. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
When you need a pharmacy, Drive-In Drugstore has just what the doctor ordered. Located at 228 South 1st Street in Amite, Drive-In Drugstore is ready to give you the personal attention and customer service you deserve. We fill all of your prescription needs promptly and carefully, and we're happy to answer questions or concerns you may have about a particular medication. We also stock an extensive selection of over-the-counter medications, vitamins, and herbal supplements for your health and well-being. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. until 6 p.m., and on Saturdays from 8 to 2. We accept most prescription insurance plans and Medicare drug discount programs. Drive-In Drugstore in Amite.
When you want it done right the first time, take it to Jim's Paint and Body Shop. With over 30 years of automotive body repair and painting experience, Jim's works on all makes and models. Jim's is family-owned and operated. All work is guaranteed, estimates are free, and all insurance claims are welcome. Go by 55461 East Durbin Road in Independence, or give them a call at 878-2329. That's Jim's Paint and Body Shop. We do it right the first time.
Come to Buddy's Home Furnishings at 706 West Oak Street in Amite for all your home furnishing needs, including electronics, home furniture, appliances, computers, and more. Buddy's has competitive prices, big names like Ashley, LG, Samsung, Kenmore, and many more. We offer rent-to-own or 2, 4, or 6 months same as cash with no credit checks, and same-day delivery is available. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you. Own it faster for less at Buddy's Home Furnishings in Amite and Hammond.
Injured on the field, hurt on the job, been in a car accident? The doctors at Anton's Chiropractic Care will help you get back to pre-injury performance level. With treatments including chiropractic adjustments, physical therapy, and massage therapy, you will quickly begin seeing results. Anton's even schedules Saturday appointments to ensure that your treatment will not interfere with your schedule. So give them a call at 985-542-1640 to schedule your appointment, or stop by their downtown location in Hammond across from the Columbia Theater. That's Anton's Chiropractic Care for all your chiropractic needs.
If you want our lowest prices on our best selection of new and used vehicles, then visit the Bill Hood family of dealerships, Louisiana's low price leader, or click hoodauto.com. Visit Bill Hood Ford Lincoln in Hammond, Bill Hood Nissan, Mazda, and Hyundai on the import corner in Hammond, Bill Hood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Amite, Bill Hood Chevrolet in Covington, plus our two new stores, Bill Hood Premium Pre-Owned in Hammond and Bill Hood Pre-Owned Outlet in Ponchatoula. Click hoodauto.com.
Robbie Miller loves Tangipahoa Parish. Whether you have lived here your whole life or just moved here, Robbie is committed to you. It's time for Tangipahoa to play the next play. Please vote October 24th, Robbie Miller for our parish president. New innovative leadership for the future of Tangipahoa Parish.
We go to the second quarter, a big third down and long for the Wolves. Johnson drops the throw and immediately going to try to run it upfield, but they were waiting on him. Nowhere to go for Johnson. He'll lose two on the play. Johnson a little quick back there. Wasn't getting pressured to tuck that ball and run. So it'll bring up fourth down for the Wolves in a punting situation. Might be a little frustration starting to set in on Johnson. He's got to go to the sidelines and settle down a little bit. Going to have to find a way to throw the football and involve other people as they're starting to key, especially on him.
Sure, Coach Messina told his punter here this time, let's try to keep it away from these guys back there. And we have a timeout by the Loranger Bulls.
Loranger takes their timeout, first of the half. Reed set the punt, gets it away, high end over end kick, This is Jones from the 24-yard line to the sideline, and a flag flies. Two flags on the field.
Looks like it could have been a block in the back, dog.
Might be the first penalty of the night against the Warriors. A lot of flags early in this ball game. Don't understand why you have to have a huddle after every flag, though.
Well, they've already waved two off, so I guess, look, they got one up here, two, they threw two back there. Might be two penalties. A lot of confusion out there.
Taking a lot of time to figure this one out. And you know Amy just wants to get on the field with the football. Personal foul, face mask against
Loranger.
Loranger, then they had a penalty against Amy, so they're offsetting, so we'll do it all again.
Face mask on the offense. That's one you don't see very often. Got hands to the face probably, you know, blocking something.
Looks like he just grabbed and jerked it, probably got mad and let his emotions get the best of him. So we'll punt it away again.
Vantage point isn't too good here tonight, so we might miss a few things that we normally catch.
Coach Messina livid on the sideline. Gets off a pretty good punt here, headed toward the sideline. It'll take a Loranger bounce and no return, more importantly. So the Warriors will be back up here with their offensive possession. Next week, the AT will be on the road back in Hammond as the Hammond High Tours take on the St. Paul Wolves, a tough task over there in Tornado Alley.
Yeah, St. Paul beat Denham Springs High School last week pretty handedly, and you know, Hammond's trying to get things on track there, but it's going to be a tough one in Tornado Alley.
Well, you know, Hammond in a tough district, but they played some tough non-district games also. Coach Cecil Thomas trying to get things on track there by the Tours, for the Tours. So we'll see them next week. Here in Loranger, it's 13-0 Amite. Amite takes over. Harrell up the right side. Gets out across the 25-yard line, gain of 8. Starting to see that Amite offensive line open some holes here for Harrell on these last two possessions.
That was a little hint of Amite of old there. At the speed play, which opened up the hole for Harrell to hit the dive.
What you have to like about a Kenner Harrell is he's all north and south. He doesn't play around back there. That time hit at the line of scrimmage, able to bang forward and pick up the first down. First down at the 29-yard line.
Going a little no huddle. Using the wristband, staying on the line of scrimmage.
Things have gotten so sophisticated in football. You see the wristbands. You know, I worked during the day at SNS Sports Center. I had a lady come in yesterday looking for a wristband for a 6-year-old. Gain of 5 there off the right side. And the only thing I'm thinking is, do you write in the wristband in crayon?
As long as it stays in between the lines, that's all you can do.
Second down and a long 4.
But you're right, it's getting a little ridiculous. In a lot of sports, not just football. My favorite has to be the signs with SpongeBob and the Coke and all that other stuff, you know. Those cracked me up.
Speed play, Warriors. Brings around left end out to the 40. Milton Sanders on the carry, gets another first down as they're out to the 40-yard line. City Warriors with a couple of first downs here running the football. And that right there was vintage Amite.
And what do? Do you key on Harold and stay inside, or do you worry about them getting that speed and running to the outside?
And that's what they've done for a lot of years and working it here tonight. Coach Powell knew when he walked into Amite what he was walking into. To quote Coach Powell, to me, the gold standard in the parish is Amite, and there is nothing else. So he knows.
Amite's going to get a free five right here.
Offsides against the Wolves. And the Wolves can't afford to keep making these mistakes here. They cannot afford to go down any further. Already down 13-0 here in the second quarter. Walker trots on. He'll be in the shotgun. Zips a pass to Smith. It's complete. He breaks free, headed toward the corner. Steps out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Another big catch, but Smith showing a lot here at wide receiver.
And, you know, that's just the old typical Amite speed. He had a guy that was right behind him as he made that jump cut, and he just left. If he doesn't get tripped up there, I think he might take that to the distance. Nice pass by Walker. Had a lot of momentum on that ball.
Walker, a lot of zip on that pass, and it gives them a first down and 10 at the 13-yard line. Amite on the move again, already leading 13-0. Quarterback keeper off the right side. Mitchell gets a couple, but that's all. Loranger, good job tying him up there. Tackle made by number 17, Jabari Costin, along with a few of his friends. Jaquan Thomas in on the bottom there also. Gain of one on the play. It'll be second down and 9. Timeout, Amite. Second and 9 from the 12. Kenner Harrell, right side, hit immediately, breaks a tackle, spins outside, still on his feet, touchdown.
Wow.
Nice run there by Harrell, and a little bit of sloppy tackling by the Wolves gives the Warriors a touchdown, and we got a player down. So touchdown stands. It is 19-0 as Dokes will attempt a point after. Kicks up straight away, and it's good. So it's 20-0 Warriors here in the first half. Loranger shell-shocked right now. We'll have to find a way here before halftime to put something together and get some points on the board, or this could turn into a long night.
When you want it done right the first time, take it to Jim's Paint and Body Shop. With over 30 years of automotive body repair and painting experience, Jim's works on all makes and models. Jim's is family-owned and operated. All work is guaranteed, estimates are free, and all insurance claims are welcome. Go by 55461 East Durbin Road in Independence, or give them a call at 878-2329. That's Jim's Paint and Body Shop. We do it right the first time.
Robbie Miller loves Tanchpo Parish. Whether you have lived here your whole life or just moved here, Robbie is committed to you. It's time for Tanchpo to play the next play. Please vote October 24th, Robbie Miller, for our parish president. New innovative leadership for the future of Tanchpo Parish.
If you want our lowest prices on our best selection of new and used vehicles, then visit the Bill Hood family of dealerships, Louisiana's low price leader, or click hoodauto.com. Visit Bill Hood Ford Lincoln in Hammond, Bill Hood Nissan, Mazda, and Hyundai on the import corner in Hammond, Bill Hood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Amite, Bill Hood Chevrolet in Covington, plus our two new stores, Bill Hood Premium Pre-Owned in Hammond and Bill Hood Pre-Owned Outlet in Ponchatoula. Click hoodauto.com.
Amite to kick it away here. Dokes high end over end kick. The Wolves bring it up the right side out to the 30 and knocked down at the 30. Creighton Cook on the tackle. So first and 10, Wolves at their own 30-yard line, trailing now by 20. And like I said, not knowing how much time is left here in this first half, you would think, though, if there's any amount of time, the Wolves cannot afford to be a three and out quick here. Amite's got all the momentum right now. You have to at least run out the rest of this first half or get some points. Johnson, keeper, right off the left side. He's hit at the line of scrimmage and brought down. We'll pick up a couple yards. Treyon Cook on the tackle, and I can tell you right now, Amite is just sitting back keying on Johnson.
Well, like you said earlier, you know, he's not looking to give the ball up too many other areas. He's trying to do it all himself, and he can't do that. He's going to have to do some things to get the ball in some other people's hands. And the one time they did that, they had success on a drive.
Second and seven. They give him three on the original carry. Green, right side. Gain of about four. It'll be third down and short. Hookfin gets up limping.
A lot of time here taken by the Wolves. It's not a bad thing.
Like I said, without knowing how much time's left, you know, maybe you're thinking, hey, we'll run as much as we can in case we don't get it on third down, but really need to pick up the first down here. It'll be Johnson from the shotgun on third and 2.5. Johnson on the keeper. Gets to the outside, spins, breaks a tackle. He's out near midfield.
Good hard running by Johnson.
And Johnson gets him a first down at the Amite 47-yard line. Player down on the field. First down and 10 for the Wolves. Once again, Johnson fakes and tries to keep it off the right side. He gets a nice run there on first down of about six.
Good job by big number 62, Wade Bayham, getting out there and leading through that hole. Nice gain for the Wolves.
Down to inside the 41-yard line of the Warriors. So the Wolves trying to get something on the board here to cut into this 20-0 lead here before the half. Second and four. Handoff left side to Green. He's hitting the backfield and will be dropped for a big loss.
And you see Coach Messina talking about the forward progress. But when he bounced out of that first tackle and tried to run again, and that's where they're going to spot that ball.
Absolutely. Once he bounced off, he was free to turn upfield, and that's when they hit him. So a loss of seven on the play. It'll be third down and 11. And that's one of those plays that is a drive killer. See the band going down to the sideline. Must be getting close to halftime here as we're guessing without a clock. Timeout on the field, Loranger. Third down and 11 for the Wolves. Johnson looking to throw. Here comes the pressure. Going to tuck it and keep it again. Trying to get to the outside. Breaks the tackle. Still on his feet. We'll turn it up and pick up the first down. So there's that playmaking ability. Warriors have him stopped, but Johnson gets him down to inside the 30. First down Wolves at the 29-yard line.
What a great run right there. The ability to drop the hand and keep moving forward. Big play there by Johnson. Again, LaRonge attempting to throw the ball there, but the pressure was just too much for him. Had to tuck and run there.
First and 10 from the shotgun. Swing pass to the outside to Green, complete. He turns up the left side. He's got 10 and another first down. Good job by Johnson to get rid of it. It's their disregard to everybody and going after him now, but he completes a short pass. It turns into another first down for the Wolves.
Big drive right here for the Wolves. They can get some points in before half and have something to build on coming out. They will get the football.
Definitely looking for a touchdown here as they are down 20 to nothing. They meet. Loranger can score late here and keep Amite the rest of the half. They'll get the ball to start the second half. Green, right side, down to the 10. Pick up a 5. It'll be second and 5.
You know, that's the thing, dog, tonight. Loranger really hadn't been stopped for many losses. You know, they've been getting some good yardage on their carries. Penalties and mistakes have been hurting them so far.
Second and 5, Warriors showing blitz. Nice spin move by Johnson. We'll get inside the 5, down to the 4, and a first and goal for the Wolves. The Warriors bringing in some beef there on the defensive line. They had went small.
I want to say that I saw the guy on the field keeping the clock saying it's 3 minutes, right at 3 minutes left in this half.
Right there, blew the center up, but Johnson able to spin to the outside and get in for the touchdown. So the Wolves are on the board here, 21-6 your score. A little bit of a broken play there by Johnson, and he was able to bounce it to the outside. You saw the defensive lineman blow the center up, knocking back into the quarterback as soon as he did, but Johnson's athletic ability got him to the outside and cuts the lead to 14. Reed to come in to try the point after. Unofficially under 3 minutes to go here in the half. Nice kick by Reed, and it's 20-7. Reed to kick it away. Loranger does that directional kick. Let's see if they kick it short and toward the sideline. He turns and kicks it deep. Nice job by Reed into the end zone for the touchback. So AB, with just a couple of minutes left here in the opening half, has the football first and 10 from the 20, leading it 20-7. First down, 10. Handoff up the middle to Harrell, not much there. Stop for a gain of 1 on the play. It'll bring up second down and 9.
You got to think here, dog. Soon they're going to go back to that deep route and try to see if they can run by these Loranger defenders.
Roger got burned on the opening play of the game by this Amite offense for a 67-yard touchdown, Walker to Smith. Pressure coming, Walker rolls left. Going to be sacked and a big loss on the play. Good job by Loranger's defense here.
Jabari Costin came off the edge that time, bringing Walker down for the big sack. You know, that's what we saw earlier. He was coming off that corner, but he was getting sucked inside. Walker was able to get out.
Loss of play, 8 on the play. It'll be a timeout by the Warriors. Third down and 18 from the Warriors. Backed up at their own 11-yard line. Mitchell caught near the end zone. Being swarmed, breaks tackle, still on his feet. And will be knocked out of bounds after about a 2-yard gain, forcing a punt by the Warriors. Good job once again by this Loranger defensive line getting pressure on the quarterback.
Walker Bailey got out of the end zone there. did a good job of escaping. That was a swarming Wolves defense there. And they're going to get the ball back here. We're not sure of the time, dog, but at least have a shot.
Bad snap. Warriors going to go for it here. Big hole on the right side. Got one man to beat. He'll pick up the first down, but we have a flag down, I believe.
I believe somebody on the Amite line moved before the snap.
And it is against Amite, an illegal shift, so a big play there. Going to be negated. Wise choice there by the punter to run as nobody was on the right side. But a line, they had an illegal shift. Big break there by Loranger, or for Loranger, excuse me.
You're definitely going to need to have somebody out there this time. That's not your average punter. He will be deep in his own end zone here, dog. This is going to be a big snap and punt here for the Warriors.
Travis Lamb stands at his own 45-yard line awaiting the punt of Dokes. Bad snap. Pressure on. They got a finger on it. It's blocked. And Loranger comes up with it at the 14-yard line, so we might have ourselves a ball game here. Somehow Loranger could score here before the half and actually get the ball to start the second half. You could easily have them taking the lead here.
That's what I was saying. What a big snap. Nerves get high down there. Tension builds, and that snap tends to rise. They did a good job of getting back in there and getting a piece of that ball.
And we talked about being teams that don't make penalties. That was a big penalty that negated the first down. Now you get the block punt, and Loranger with a chance to get right back in this ball game here. Unofficially, about a minute to go here in the half, maybe a little less.
I'm going to say they have about one timeout, maybe.
Green up the middle. Wilson had him around the waist, drops him down. Gain of 3, second down and 7.
There is a minute. They are taking a long time here.
Once again, Green up the middle. This time, Sopcher. That's Rodney, who drops him for a loss. Timeout, Loranger. Third down and 9. Amite jumps off sides. We'll give him an easy 5. Big penalty against the Warriors.
Loranger.
From my vantage point, I can only see a couple of
lines. That's what I
say.
I only saw Loranger.
I saw Amite jump across.
And I only saw Loranger because I couldn't see the line. The wide out for Loranger moved.
I can't see the wide out. I can barely see the middle of the field, so let's see what the call is. And it is against Loranger. They'll back him up 5. It'll be 3rd down and 14. A little confusion on the Loranger sideline. Looking to throw. Throws it toward the end zone, toward the corner. Pass caught for a touchdown. DeAndre Brown went up and brought it down.
What a turnaround right here at the end of this half by Loranger Wolves. Putting up 2 quick touchdowns. Capitalizing on some of the Amite Warriors' mistakes.
So 20-13, and like we said, Loranger will have it to start the second half. So a big turnaround here at the first half. Coach Powell and the Warriors just kind of cruising around here through most of the first half, but the Wolves have come back. Reed's point after is good. It's 20-14, Warriors. Loranger to kick it away. They have cut this lead by 14. It's now only trailing by 6 here. under a minute to go here in the first half. High end-over-end kick, headed out of bounds. So obviously not enough time left where they want to give Amite a chance to get a big run back there.
And I think he's going to take the penalty and get the ball at the 35-yard line, though. We do know the quick hit capability of the Amite Warriors, so if it's 42, 40 seconds left, that's enough for them.
Well, after we've seen the big return, I might want to back them up and make them kick it again. Keep kicking it out of bounds because the clock doesn't start until somebody touches it. Eventually, you're going to get a chance to return one. But
exactly.
Coach Powell decides to take the ball to the 35-yard line, or it'll be first down and 10 Warriors.
53 seconds, I saw, given by the official, the hand signal.
And what was a comfortable 20-point lead has been shrunken by the Wolves.
Oh, my goodness.
Mitchell's going to throw it in the ground, intended for his receiver out there in the right flat. Be second down and 10.
They were lucky on that with that high snap. Walker was able to run right underneath it.
Another high snap. Big sack, and the Wolves will push him back. And you know Coach Messina would like to force Amite to punt the football here if he can. Not sure how much time's left.
We're somewhere around the 20-second mark or so. It was 53 to start the
Well, if that's the case, they could just let the clock run out here if you're Amite.
Looks like that's what they're going to do.
I mean, if you're not going to throw it deep, why in the world would you even run a play here? And they're going to walk off the field and take it to halftime. Your score, AB 20, Loranger 14.
Robbie Miller loves Tanchpo Parish. Whether you have lived here your whole life or just moved here, Robbie is committed to you. It's time for Tanchpo to play the next play. Please vote October 24th, Robbie Miller, for our parish president. New innovative leadership for the future of Tanchpo Parish.
If you want our lowest prices on our best selection of new and used vehicles, then visit the Bill Hood family of dealerships, Louisiana's low price leader, or click hoodauto.com. Visit Bill Hood Ford Lincoln in Hammond, Bill Hood Nissan, Mazda, and Hyundai on the import corner in Hammond, Bill Hood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Amite, Bill Hood Chevrolet in Covington, plus our two new stores, Bill Hood Premium Pre-Owned in Hammond and Bill Hood Pre-Owned Outlet in Ponchatoula. Click hoodauto.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Bailey, and I'm running for state representative in District 73. As a hard-working small business owner, I understand the strains of an oversized government. My opponent believes that higher taxes and more taxes is the key to our budget issues. He voted in this past session for 9 bills that would increase taxes on individuals and businesses alike. He even authored a bill in the legislature that would raise an estimated of $500 million. I believe in job creation, small businesses, and free enterprise is the key to our budget issues. Join me October 24th and vote for a better Tanchpahoa.
Injured on the field, hurt on the job, been in a car accident? The doctors at Anton's Chiropractic Care will help you get back to pre-injury performance level. With treatments including chiropractic adjustments, physical therapy, and massage therapy, you will quickly begin seeing results. Anton's even schedules Saturday appointments to ensure that your treatment will not interfere with your schedule. So give them a call at 985-542-1640 to schedule your appointment or stop by their downtown location in Hammond across from the Columbia Theater. That's Anton's Chiropractic Care for all your chiropractic needs.
Dixie RV Superstore is your number one source for the largest selection of new and pre-owned RVs. You're sure to find the RV of your dreams with 68 acres of motorhomes, travel trailers, fifth wheels, and toy haulers. We also have an RV collision center and 56 service bays to better serve you. Dixie RV, located off I-12 exit 35 in Hammond. Check out DixieRV.com.
For all of your insurance needs, call State Farm agent Robbie Lee. Whether you own a house, a condominium, or live in rental property, State Farm has a policy that is right for you. We offer a wide variety of life insurance, health and disability insurance, as well as business insurance.
Hi, I'm Robbie Lee. For all your insurance needs, stop by 227 Northwest Central Avenue in Amite. We'll take care of you.
Robbie Lee and his friendly staff will gladly assist you. Call them today at 985-748-9000. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
When you need a pharmacy, Drive-In Drugstore has just what the doctor ordered. Located at 228 South 1st Street in Amite, Drive-In Drugstore is ready to give you the personal attention and customer service you deserve. We fill all of your prescription needs promptly and carefully, and we're happy to answer questions or concerns you may have about a particular medication. We also stock an extensive selection of over-the-counter medications, vitamins, and herbal supplements for your health and well-being. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. until 6 p.m., and on Saturdays from 8 to 2. We accept most prescription insurance plans and Medicare drug discount programs. Drive-In Drugstore in Amite.
When you want it done right the first time, take it to Jim's Paint and Body Shop. With over 30 years of automotive body repair and painting experience, Jim's works on all makes and models. Jim's is family owned and operated. All work is guaranteed, estimates are free, and all insurance claims are welcome. Go by 55461 East Durbin Road in Independence, or give them a call at 878-2329. That's Jim's Paint and Body Shop. We do it right the first time.
Come to Buddy's Home Furnishings at 706 West Oak Street in Amite for all your home furnishing needs, including electronics, home furniture, appliances, computers, and more. Buddy's has competitive prices, big names like Ashley, LG, Samsung, Kenmore, and many more. We offer rent-to-own or 2-4 or 6-month same as cash with no credit checks, and same-day delivery is available. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you. Own it faster for less at Buddy's Home Furnishings in Amite and Hammond.
Watching WSTY TV, Channel 23, Hammond, Ponchatoula.
So, halftime, your score, Amite 20, Loranger 14, a tale of Amite dominated for a quarter and a half, and then Loranger made a big push at halftime to cut the lead, and now they'll have the ball to start the second half. Your WSTY game of the week. Want to apologize up front. We have a terrible vantage point. We can't really see much of the field, so we're going to do our best here. No clock as the scoreboard is out. So we'll probably sound pretty uninformed, but we'll do the best we can. First down and 10, looks like the 41-yard line. Roger did a much better job late in the first half of mixing in the running game instead of relying solely on Evan Johnson. A little movement up front. AB jumps offsides, flags fly. It's going to be offsides against the Warriors. Five-yard penalty gets it out to the 46-yard line.
This is a drive that Loranger is going to have to put in and get some points here. They want to keep being in this ball game.
Well, I think all the momentum has switched Loranger's way now, in control if they can keep it rolling. Green off the right side, cross midfield, down to the 49 and close to a first down.
And they're going to give it to him there.
It'll be first down and 10 inside Warrior territory already here in the early third quarter. Johnson on the keeper, picks up about 10 and close to another first down, be a little bit shy. Ball now at the Amite 40-yard line.
Yeah.
looked like the snap happened and nobody else moved, and Amy went across and dropped him for about a 2-yard loss. So it's a miscommunication there by the Wolves.
Go from a second and one to now a second and third and four.
The only two that knew the snap count was the center and the quarterback. No lineman moved at all.
And he is swarmed by the Amy Warrior defense, short of the first down.
Green on the dive, not much there. It'll bring up fourth down and three in decision time for Coach Messina. It looks like they'll punt it away here.
Defense held strong going into halftime. Let's see if their defense can come back out in the second half and do what they did at the end.
And if you Warriors got to be real careful here, you can't give up a fake. Smith back deep to receive at his own nine. Punts away, headed towards Smith. He's going to let it bounce, takes it on the bounce at the five. Gets it out to the 20 on his feet, breaks two tackles, got one man to beat, trips over on his feet, but he'll get it across midfield down to the 45-yard line, and that's why you wanted to kick it away and let your coverage go get it. You want to give this young man a chance. That's two big punt returns. They turned the last one into a touchdown. Let's see what they do with their opening drive here in the third quarter.
Here comes Walker and that Amy Warrior offense. Let's see if they continue to try to get the ball outside quick or if they take a shot here early.
Well, they started out throwing, then it was Harrell who had some success. Then the Loranger defense shut them down late. There's Harrell. Once again, he's hit right at the line of scrimmage. Nowhere to go. Number 52 on the tackle is Malcolm Perry. Had a little help from his friends, but they drop him for no gain. Harrell again, right side, runs it to a pile, bounces it outside. Will pick up about five. Forced out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Brings up third down and five. Fakes to Harrell. Walker keeps it left side. Nothing there. It'll bring up fourth down and four.
What is Coach Powell going to do here?
Well, Coach Messina chose to punt, pinned them deep, but the big return gave Eats a favor. Now do they go for it or do they try to pin Loranger deep? Looks like the offense is staying on the field. They'll go for it on fourth down and a long four. Must reach the 35-yard line for a first down. The Rogers showing blitz. And we're going to get a timeout by the Warriors. Big fourth down play for the Warriors here early third quarter. Walker throws nowhere near his receiver. Incomplete at the Wolves hold and will get the football back at their own 40-yard line. First down and 10. So here comes the Wolves offense out for the second time here in the second half. Johnson, keeper up the middle. Pick up a two. Big number 66 at the bottom of the pile. Ishmael Sopcher. Second down and eight. I'd like to thank our sponsors for tonight's game, Dixie RV Superstore, Bill Hood Automotive Group, Anthon's Chiropractic Clinic, Robbie Miller, Tim Bailey, Drive-In Drugstore, Jim's Paint and Body Shop, State Farm, Robbie Lee, and Buddy's Home Furnishings. Without them, we wouldn't be here. And here comes Green trying to get to the outside. Smith broke down and just didn't even get a hand on him. Not a good job out there by Smith. He was able to get to the outside, gets him close to the first down. He's got to force that run back to the middle to his help.
Anytime you're the guy outside and you square up, there's no way you're going to do that job. You should have continued to run and brought it back inside.
So third down and let's call it a yard and a half for the Wolves here. Mid third quarter, they trail by six. Green again to the outside, the inside Warrior territory, and first down for the Wolves.
I tell you, those Wolves receivers are doing a good job of getting their hands out there on those defensive backs and getting a good push and keeping them occupied so he can get that corner.
Well, right now, the Amite defender's not getting up the field to force the play. Sitting back trying to break down. Well, it's too late by the time they get there. He had the first down at the 49-yard line. Johnson from the shotgun. Fakes a handoff, we got a flag down. Loranger takes a timeout before they snap the football.
Dixie RV Superstore is your number one source for the largest selection of new and pre-owned RVs. You're sure to find the RV of your dreams with 68 acres of motorhomes, travel trailers, fifth wheels, and toy haulers. We also have an RV collision center and 56 service bays to better serve you. Dixie RV, located off I-12 exit 35 in Hammond. Check out DixieRV.com.
When you need a pharmacy, Drive-In Drugstore has just what the doctor ordered. Located at 228 South 1st Street in Amite, Drive-In Drugstore is ready to give you the personal attention and customer service you deserve. We fill all of your prescription needs promptly and carefully, and we're happy to answer questions or concerns you may have about a particular medication. We also stock an extensive selection of over-the-counter medications, vitamins, and herbal supplements for your health and well-being. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. until 6 p.m., and on Saturdays from 8 to 2. We accept most prescription insurance plans and Medicare drug discount programs. Drive-In Drugstore in Amite.
Injured on the field, hurt on the job, been in a car accident? The doctors at Anton's Chiropractic Care will help you get back to pre-injury performance level. With treatments including chiropractic adjustments, physical therapy, and massage therapy, you will quickly begin seeing results. Anton's even schedules Saturday appointments to ensure that your treatment will not interfere with your schedule. So give them a call at 985-542-1640 to schedule your appointment or stop by their downtown location in Hammond across from the Columbia Theater. That's Anton's Chiropractic Care for all your chiropractic needs.
Whistle blows, first down and 10 for the Wolves. Snap bobbled. Johnson hit in the backfield. He'll be dropped for a yard loss. Number 12 for the Warriors, Devin Atkins, got him.
In the backfield again, big Mark Wilson.
Causing a little bit of havoc there in the middle of that line. But the high snap, and maybe Johnson took his eye off it for a second. Throw the timing off of the play. It'll be second down and 12.
A little more confusion. They can't afford to take another timeout here.
Never know when those are going to become important late in the football game. Johnson looking to throw. Got a man going up the sideline, but he's going to run the football here, and he's going to be swinging to the outside. Looked like he was going to be sacked, but he completes the pass to Green and gets a positive gain of about 7 yards there. Made something out of nothing. So we have the water break here in the middle of the third quarter. Your score, AB 20, Loranger 14. Third down and 4 for the Wolves. Jackson went off the play, was suffering from cramps. Amite almost jumps. Now some confusion by the Wolves.
Third
Handoff left side and a first down. Big run by number six, Alex Williams. Young sophomore picks up the first down, down to the 35-yard line.
I tell you, dog, the Warriors had nobody deep on that play. Everybody was up toward the line of scrimmage. We'll see if Loranger on this first down takes a shot.
Warriors stacking the box, trying to stop the run. Only pass that had been completed by Loranger was short. Williams again, right side, pick up a four. Getting some fresh legs in there running the football. Loranger trails by six midway through the third quarter. On the move inside Warrior territory, they have a second down and seven from the 31-yard line. Once again, a keeper by Johnson. Not much there. Might have got a yard down to the 30.
That time he tried to get outside, he should have stayed up the field and he gotten a few more yards there. Big third down here for the Wolves.
Once again, next week we'll be in Hammond as the St. Paul's Wolves come to town in that big 5A matchup with the Tornadoes. St. Paul's in the previous few years has become a powerhouse in 5A. Torres looking to rebuild. Third down, long five. Johnson looking to throw, got a man wide open over the middle. Pass dropped in and out of the hands of Keenan Curry. Had it at about the 9-yard line, but dropped it. So to bring up fourth down. And that's what you do when they keep creeping in, putting everybody in the box. You sneak that tight end up the middle, and they did it, had him open. Good play call, but it'll still be fourth down.
That's what I was talking about earlier. They had nobody deep. They ran that seam route. He's wide open. He's got to come down with that.
Well, you know, until you could prove that you could throw the ball down the field, they're going to keep keeping those guys up. But that one throw there might loosen it up just enough. Johnson looking to throw. Being pressured backside. Hit as he throws. Flag on the play. Depending on the penalty here, it should be Amy's football unless it's against the Warriors. Let's see as the sideline official comes in. First down, Warriors. Once again, another flag being waved off. I mean, just can't seem to get it together here tonight, folks.
That's three.
Between us not being able to see the scoreboard out and the officials, this is not a very good night for football.
Once again, that Wolves defense is going to have to step up here. They've been called upon a few times here tonight to stop the Warriors and see if they can do it again.
Well, they've kept this Warriors offense scoreless since early second quarter, so now to keep doing the job they've been doing. Low snap. Walker to the outside, completes a flat pass, swings upfield, gain of about two or three.
He is hit hard on the sideline.
Jones on the move there, got stuck on the sideline. Big hit by the Wolves. They pick up a three. You know, I keep looking down to the lower side of the field. Big number 11 looks to be about 6'5 down there, and they've yet to throw him the football, the senior. Low snap again, flag on the play, mishandled will hand off. Walker will keep it, two flags on the field. Let's see if it's the same penalty or two different ones. Or if they're gonna wave it off.
Let's see if they wave this off, let's make it four.
Looks like he's talking to Coach Powell. It might be against Loranger. I'm not sure. But now they walk it back against Amite. So I don't know what's going on.
I'm telling you.
Nope. Not- the official walked in the wrong direction. It is against Loranger. So a comedy of errors here.
Good Lord.
Second down and one. Harrell, left side, has the first down out to the 45-yard line. Good hold there on that left side.
You know, I'm like you, dog. You got number 11 out here, and he is a good-looking wide receiver, and they have single coverage, nobody over the top of him.
Well, he's got to be 6'5", and looks like he might have a 5'10 guy trying to guard him. Sooner or later, you got to throw the football up and see if he can make a play. Harrell straight up the middle, right into the pile. Pile moves, might have got a yard. Kenner Harrell is your bread and butter, but you keep pounding, pounding, then you take your shot. It's just a matter of when and do you convert it. We just saw it with Loranger, pounded, pounded, finally took their shot up the middle, unable to convert, came away empty-handed. So it's 20-14, the Warriors lead it here in the WSTY Game of the Week in Rusty Chambers Field and Loranger. Harrell, right side, big hole out there, cuts it up, will pick up about six. Puts the Warriors in a third and about three. Make it four, ball at the 49-yard line. They have to get to the 45. So back and forth battle here in the third quarter, no points scored so far. Both teams able to pick up a few first downs, but then stall. So let's see if the Warriors can convert here on third down.
Got to be close to the end of the quarter, we assume.
Walker shotgun gives it to Harrell, left side. He's hit the backfield. Nice play by number 51 for the Wolves, Lionel Scott.
Good penetration right there to make the play.
And it will force the Warriors to punt the football, so some pretty good defense being played out here by both teams.
Remember earlier, they got a penalty when Dokes took the snap and took off to the right side and gained a lot of yards to get the first down. It was called back early in the first half.
I don't think Loranger will be fooled by that again, but he gets off a bad punt and out of bounds, and he gets a punt off of about 12 yards, so Loranger with good field position. Almost would have been just as good to go for it there. First down and 10 for the Wolves, late third quarter, trailing by six. Swing pass to the outside, completed. Up the field goes Curry. Knocked out of bounds at the 47-yard line, about a yard shy of a first down. And those are the tight plays Loranger has to do. Johnson, a great athlete back there. Green's running hard, but you got to mix in some plays to the outside and over the middle to keep this defense offline. And there goes.
He's going down
Green
the sideline.
On the sideline. Knocked out of bounds around the 20-yard line. So a big play there by the Wolves offense.
Amite had some confusion right there. They had 12 on the field. They were trying to get somebody off. They weren't lined up in the right position.
Loranger trying to run the hurry up here. You got the Warriors back on their heels. And that's the end of the third.
Hi, I'm Tim Bailey, and I'm running for state representative here in District 73. I plan to enhance our vocational education system so that we have job-ready graduates. I also plan to create an economic development plan for our region. South Tangipahoa Parish is in need of a bridge of representation. I'm asking for your vote on October 24th, and allow me to be that bridge for you.
Dixie RV Superstore is your number one source for the largest selection of new and pre-owned RVs. You're sure to find the RV of your dreams with 68 acres of motorhomes, travel trailers, fifth wheels, and toy haulers. We also have an RV collision center and 56 service bays to better serve you. Dixie RV, located off I-12 exit 35 in Hammond. Check out DixieRV.com.
For all of your insurance needs, call State Farm agent Robbie Lee. Whether you own a house or condominium or live in rental property, State Farm has a policy that is right for you. We offer a wide variety of life insurance, health and disability insurance, as well as business insurance.
Hi, I'm Robbie Lee. For all your insurance needs, stop by 227 Northwest Central Avenue in Amite. We'll take care of you.
Robbie Lee and his friendly staff will gladly assist you. Call them today at 985-748-9000. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
When you need a pharmacy, Drive-In Drugstore has just what the doctor ordered. Located at 228 South 1st Street in Amite, Drive-In Drugstore is ready to give you the personal attention and customer service you deserve. We fill all of your prescription needs promptly and carefully, and we're happy to answer questions or concerns you may have about a particular medication. We also stock an extensive selection of over-the-counter medications, vitamins, and herbal supplements for your health and well-being. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. until 6 p.m., and on Saturdays from 8 to 2. We accept most prescription insurance plans and Medicare drug discount programs. Drive-In Drugstore in Amite.
When you want it done right the first time, take it to Jim's Paint and Body Shop. With over 30 years of automotive body repair and painting experience, Jim's works on all makes and models. Jim's is family-owned and operated. All work is guaranteed, estimates are free, and all insurance claims are welcome. Go by 55461 East Durbin Road in Independence or give them a call at 878-2329. That's Jim's Paint and Body Shop. We do it right the first time.
Come to Buddy's Home Furnishings at 706 West Oak Street in Amite for all your home furnishing needs, including electronics, home furniture, appliances, computers, and more. Has competitive prices, big names like Ashley, LG, Samsung, Kenmore, and many more. We offer rent-to-own or 2-4 or 6 months same as cash with no credit checks, and same-day delivery is available. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you. Own it faster for less at Buddy's Home Furnishings in Amite and Hammond.
Injured on the field, hurt on the job, been in a car accident? The doctors at Anton's Chiropractic Care will help you get back to pre-injury performance level. With treatments including chiropractic adjustments, physical therapy, and massage therapy, you will quickly begin seeing results. Anton's even schedules Saturday appointments to ensure that your treatment will not interfere with your schedule. So give them a call at 985-542-1640 to schedule your appointment or stop by their downtown location in Hammond across from the Columbia Theater. That's Anton's Chiropractic Care for all your chiropractic needs.
If you want our lowest prices on our best selection of new and used vehicles, then visit the Bill Hood family of dealerships, Louisiana's low price leader, or click hoodauto.com. Visit Bill Hood Ford Lincoln in Hammond, Bill Hood Nissan, Mazda, and Hyundai on the import corner in Hammond, Bill Hood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Amite, Bill Hood Chevrolet in Covington, plus our two new stores, Bill Hood Premium Pre-Owned in Hammond and Bill Hood Pre-Owned Outlet in Ponchatoula. Click hoodauto.com.
Robbie Miller loves Tanchpo Parish. Whether you have lived here your whole life or just moved here, Robbie is committed to you. It's time for Tanchpo to play the next play. Please vote October 24th, Robbie Miller for our parish president. New innovative leadership for the future of Tanchpo Parish.
We start the fourth quarter with the Wolves trailing by six, but inside Warrior territory, all the way down to the 23. Johnson on the keeper. Had one man to beat, but a nice tackle out there by number 33 for the Warriors, Jackson. Just like you write it up, he broke down, didn't let him get outside, made the tackle. No gain, it'll be second down and 10.
And that's what you gotta do. You gotta get outside. They did that with that little quick pass, that swing. Make those corners earn their money.
Ball's on the ground. Johnson picks it up, but he will be called down at the 26-yard line, a loss of three on the play. So it brings up third down and long.
You know, he's trying to ride it as long as possible and get those guys to commit on that back. He wants to pull it and get outside, but sometimes you got to live with that dive and have another play to run.
Avoiding the turnover were the Wolves, trailing by six. Third down, and let's call it 14. Whistles blow. Timeout by the Warriors. After the timeout, the Warriors come set their defense here. Know this is a big third down play. Johnson looking to throw, but he's also looking for a place to run. Now he sprints to the outside. Once again, the corner doing a terrible job of sealing. Seems like they underestimate the quickness of Johnson here. That's a couple of times they had him perfectly, and he just was able to outrun the coverage.
Well, they finally had some decent protection where he could sit back in the pocket. They got some guys up the field and in coverage, so he was able to get to the outside and get the first down.
Well, that's the thing. It looked like they laid back and weren't trying to rush him that time, just try to spread out and keep him in the pocket. He was still able to get to the outside. So give Johnson a lot of credit there. Evan doing a good job here. The junior quarterback for the Wolves has a first down and 10 at about the 12-yard line. Hand off to Green. He slips. Still will pick up a couple of yards. Be second and 8. Ball marked just inside the 10-yard line. And this is where Loranger has to be patient. They got to make sure they get the football in the end zone here. You've made a great drive. You've got all the momentum in your favor. And with a good extra point here, you could take the lead in this ball game after trailing 20 to nothing. That's Green to the corner. Touchdown. And the Wolves have tied it here in the opening possession of the fourth quarter. Tied at 20 at Rusty Chambers Field. They have outscored the Warriors 20 to nothing since early second quarter and have a chance to take the lead here.
What a good job of blocking out there on the corner, getting him to the edge. And he finished it with a nice little Superman over the pylon.
Carson Reed to put him ahead. High snap. Reed gets it up and drills it. And the Wolves have come back to take the lead. So the Wolves with the lead will kick off. Reed to put it in play from the 40. Solid, nice kick, drives the ball back into the end zone for a touchback. Little lackadaisical back there as the ball almost died and was a live ball. So the Warriors will have it first down and 10 from the 20. So on the home turf, the Loranger Wolves have turned it around to take the lead here, 21-20 in the fourth quarter. A lot of football left to play. This is how you judge your team, though. You had a big lead, you blew it, but now you got a chance to come out. So it's a test right here for Coach Powell and his Warriors, his first year at the helm there. Coach Messina's seen it all before, so he knows what's going on here.
And you know, we were talking during the break right there. We'd like to see him open it up a little bit. Look what they're doing out here, dog. Double receiver stacked.
On both sides. Think about it is, you were able to beat him deep on the first play and you had to throw deep since. And then it opens up the middle for Harrell. There he goes. Nice block there by Smith. Harrell's going to cut it back 45, 40, step out of bounds at the 38-yard line. And you put both those receivers out on each side, at least not very much. They can't stack the box in the middle for Harrell. Good block, opened up a hole, and Harrell did the rest.
You know, you can see that Harrell's smart back. He got what he got, and then he went out of bounds. He didn't take any unnecessary hit right there.
No unnecessary hit nor unnecessary risk of fumbling the football. You had a big play.
They're in it again.
Same formation for the Warriors.
And I can tell you,
they're waiting for a injured Wolf to get off the field.
A little play action right here, throwing it deep, might be in the books.
They pull the guard, and Harrell takes around the right side, breaks a couple of tackles, he'll get it down to the 30. Gain of 7. Didn't look like they had anything there, but those blockers, he was able to just chip it up where Harrell broke a tackle and picked up 7.
He never stops those legs from pumping, and he got through those arm tackles and picked up some yards for the Warriors here. The Wolves are going to have to stand strong like they have all night.
Harrell goes to the sideline for a breather. Milton Sanders into the game in the backfield for the Warriors. Second down, 3. Sanders going around the left side. Whistle blows it dead. Flag on the play. Legal procedure against the Warriors. That'll back them up 5. It'll be second down and 8. You know, in a tight ball game like this, you can't afford those drive-stopping penalties. You just had a big run, then you followed it up with a nice run on first down to give yourself a second and short where the playbook was wide open. And the silly 5-yard penalty execution. Sanders hit the backfield. Down low immediately was number 35, Carter LeBlanc, a name we've talked a lot over the past few years. Gets him in the backfield, drops him for a 3-yard loss. Now it's third down and 11.
Good pursuit, good penetration. Big number 51 came in there to finish it off. The Loranger defense is holding strong once again.
But look at the difference the 5-yard penalty makes. You probably wouldn't have called that play call had you been in second and 3. Walker to throw. Now being forced to the outside. He's got all day to run. Runs right through a tackle. He'll be close to the first down. See where the official marks him. He was way out of position to make the mark. Can't see. Looks like he's about a yard shy. Make it 2. It'll be fourth down and 2 for the Warriors. You hear the Loranger faithful calling for the defense.
I'd have to say this might be the biggest play of the night so far, dog. Loranger needs a big stop and then a long drive.
And I was just about to say, I cannot believe Harrell's not back in the game, and here he comes just as I say that. So fourth down and 2. Looks like there's going to be a timeout by the Warriors. Fourth and 2. Everybody on their feet. This will be Walker, left side. He has the first down.
He dropped
it. And dropped the football.
He dropped it.
It looks like Loranger has it. So Walker did not protect the football after he got the first down, and Loranger dodges a big bullet there, and now the momentum, which is already on their side, is really, really big now, because if you look at that Amite sideline, it's like you put a pin in a balloon. It is totally deflated.
And I tell you, you know, again, I don't know if this is inexperience, being a junior or whatever, but he got the first down. He's got to just go down, not fight for that extra yardage, tuck that ball away, and live to play that next down.
Well, he had the first down, lowered his shoulder, tried to run over the back, and then tried to fight for extra yards, which he didn't need at that point.
What a huge break for the Wolves.
So now it all falls on this series here. Can Loranger make a drive, burn some of this time? Amite's defense looking to make a play. Showing blitz here. Green getting to the outside. Going to be tackled down at the line of scrimmage. Not much there. Might have got a half a yard. And it's something you don't see much. Teams get to the outside against a Warrior defense. But Loranger's done a good job tonight getting to the outside. They've almost got it there.
Really good blocking, but you know what? They're fast. You know, those backs for Loranger can run.
Second down and 9. Once again, folks, no play clock, no scoreboard.
And working in the blind.
Quarterback keeper up the middle, got a hole. Johnson drops the football. Big scramble. Amy says they have it. Let's see. Warrior football.
Oh, my goodness.
So you got a gift given to you. Now you turn around and give it back. My, oh, my.
And as he's trying to get back outside, he drops the ball hitting someone's helmet.
Handoff.
Oh.
Met in the backfield.
Again.
Kenner Harrell took the handoff and then met a linebacker.
Number 35, Carter LeBlanc.
Carter LeBlanc stuffed him for a four-yard loss.
But you know, you look out there, dog. They got in that wide set. They stacked the receivers again. What did they do last time for the first big play? Give it to Harrell. Good job by the linebacker there for the Wolves.
Sooner or later, Walker was going to have to complete a pass down the field if Baby's going to win this ball game. Walker gets it back to the original line of scrimmage. This time he covers up and fights it a hole on the football. Gain of about five. Bring up third down and a long nine. Not sure if the coverage is that good, but that's about three times he's dropped back and then decided to run. Sooner or later, you got to put the football in the air and give one of them big receivers a chance to make a play.
That's right.
What a job this Loranger defense has done ever since early in the second quarter. They have taken over this game. There's the pass. There's
and
big number 11.
There he is.
That's a touchdown. Right there, there was decent coverage, but big number 11 just too big, took the ball away, broke a tackle, and scored the touchdown. And we said it. Walker had to throw the ball down the field and complete a pass for Amite, and there he does it to give him the lead back. 26-21 to score. You would almost think Amite would have to go for two here, and it looks like the offense is staying on the field.
Plenty of time left for the Wolves offense.
A extra point does them no good here, so they will go for two. Walker roll left, threw a bullet for the touchdown. Let's see, it's Harrell, left side. That's gonna be easy too, as he's basically untouched. So the Warriors come back and take the lead 28-21, and we've got another nail biter here, Rusty. Warriors to kick it off. We talked about answering the call after losing the lead, and that's exactly what they did. They turned it over, and then they come back, forced the turnover, and capitalized on it.
What?
Whistle blows it dead. Not sure. Offside against the Warriors, so they'll have to back them up five and re-kick it. They blew it dead. And those are just the kind of mistakes you cannot afford. You've taken the lead, now you're going to give them an extra 5 yards and have to kick it again.
You know, we saw it last week, Albany Springfield. The fumbles that killed them. Here you have Loranger getting the ball back on the fumble, and they put it back on the ground here now. You know, I mean, it's just been crazy. In these type of games, can't make those mistakes.
So they'll be kicking off from the 35. Loranger looks to get the football back, a decent field position with a little bit over 4 minutes left to go in this ball game unofficially. Yes. So Dokes will line it up again and kick it.
Thank you.
End-over-end kick, headed toward the sideline. Hook fin picks it up at the 21. Straight up the field. Got to hold on to the football. He does that, so great field position for Loranger. They'll have first and 10 at the 38-yard line. Like to thank our sponsors for tonight's game, Dixie RV Superstore, Bill Hood Automotive Group, Anthon's Chiropractic Clinic, Robbie Miller, candidate for parish president, Tim Bailey, candidate for state representative, District 73, Drive-In Drugstore in Amite,
brother-in-law,
Jim's Paint and Body Shop, Robbie Lee, State Farm agent in Amite, also Buddy's Home Furnishings with locations in Amite and Hammond. Thank them for helping us get on the air in a great football game. Let's see how the end here. We're looking forward to see who can make the big play and become our S&S Sports Center player of the game. Johnson on the keeper, gains about 7. Loranger in a little bit of a hurry up here. Right up the middle goes Johnson. He's going to be about a half yard shy of the first down, according to where the official is. It'll bring up third down and maybe a foot. The Warriors with the ability here to just make them earn their way down the field, keep that clock moving. Got to guess there's about 3 minutes left to go in this football game.
Yes, looked like the right tackle for Loranger.
Flag comes in flying. It'll be a legal procedure against. And what goes from a third and a half yard will now be third and 5.5. Much tougher play here for the Wolves, although you know they're in four down territory. But Coach Messina cannot be happy. Not a fan has left the stadium here as this game still hangs in the balance here. A 7-point lead for the Warriors. Late fourth quarter, Loranger with the ball at their own 44-yard line. It'll be third down and 6. Ball handed off to Green. He picks up about 3. It'll bring up a fourth down play on a do or die situation for the Wolves.
You know, Doug, when you don't have a throwing quarterback, I mean, he has a decent arm and he can do some little things there, here and there, but he's typically a runner. You get backed up, they know you're running the ball.
Roger hurries to the line on fourth down and 2. Fumbles the ball. Warriors don't even have to recover it. It'll be their ball. And a miscommunication between Johnson and Green, and that could be the ball game. What a time for a mishandled football.
Johnson's played his heart out, and he's given it his all. And, you know, those two balls he's put on the ground.
Well, let me tell you something. That is one of the hardest plays in football, to ride that ball in there and pull it out the last second. I don't know if he thought that Green was going to take it or what happened, but some miscommunication. The Warriors get it. And now all they will have to do is maybe, I don't even know how many timeouts Loranger has with no scoreboard and how much time is left, but there can't be a lot left. I think if AB can somehow find a way to get a first down, this game will be over.
I'm going to say Loranger might have 1 left.
Look for Kenner Harrell to carry this football here. There he is off the left side. Big hole. There goes Harrell up the middle, down to the 20-yard line. First down.
Good job up front by that Warrior line. Open up that hole, and like we've talked about all the time, he is explosive. When he sees the seam, he hits it and goes north and south.
Now they'll start the clock and look for AB to go in a little bit of a slowdown here. They want to run as much time off this clock as they can.
2 minutes here.
And you see the Warriors out there. They're going to let every second tick off this clock they can before they snap it as the main clock is moving. Here comes Harrell again going to the left side. This time he'll be hitting the backfield. Does a nice job of backing up, getting close to the line of scrimmage, but he'll lose a yard. Timeout, Loranger. Second down and 12. Time the ally of the Warriors. Kenner Harrell, shoulder down, gets it down to about the 16-yard line. It'll bring up third down and 4.
Looks like Coach Messina is back on the field.
Loranger must have took another timeout here. Never saw it from the officials. Third down and let's call it 5. Last timeout taken by the Wolves. Harrell runs through into the line, fighting for yardage. And of course, Loranger trying to strip the football. He's going to be close to the first down.
Looks like they're going to stop the clock to measure.
Officials timeout as they bring the chains in to measure. Either way, it'll be 25 seconds to go before they have to snap it, but if they have the first down here, you'll see victory formation for the Warriors. Butch says it's going to be short. And it's about a foot short. First one he's got right all season.
Well, you know, he is the only one that can see the game. He is standing up here in the front. We're in the back here. So you do have that luxury.
So it'll be fourth down in inches. Now, if you're Amite here, you try to let all the time run off you can, but you still want to try to pick up the first down and salt this game away.
You know, you don't try to hand it off. You don't try to do anything. You go up the middle with a quarterback.
I'm going to be honest, quarterback stick. Yes. You got a quarterback that big,
exactly.
You can't get 6 inches.
Exactly.
You don't deserve the first down.
Get a push and fall forward.
And we saw that young man before the game, and he is put together.
He is a specimen.
Under center. Of course, he may not be used to being under center. Steps left and then fights forward.
Should
have had a first down. Holds on to the football, and that'll do it for the Warriors. So let's talk about our player of the game. A couple of candidates. You have Walker's thrown the two big touchdown passes. Smith, who caught the big and had the big punt return. And then, of course, you have Kenner Harrell, who really put him on his back here in the second half running the football. What do you think, Rusty?
Well, you know, Harrell's always a good candidate, and he's done a really good job. But I got to go with Smith catching that out the blocks here, catching that big pass and having those two punt returns to put them in position to score those other touchdowns. I'm going to have to go with him tonight, but I do like the other two for sure.
So our player, S&S Sports Center, player of the game, number 3 for the Warriors, Devontae Smith, as they have come to Loranger and knocked off the Wolves. Wolves will drop to 1-3. The Warriors will improve to 3-1. Flag flies.
And why they're not in the victory formation, I don't know. They're trying to hand the ball off again.
Left side. Next week, remind everybody, we will be up at Tornado Alley in Hammond as the St. Paul's Wolves come to town. A lot of teams moving into district play starting next week. And Amite has a rematch with number 11 Livonia next week. So another big test for the Warriors, a tough preseason for the Warriors and also for Loranger. You would think after all the battles they've had that Loranger wouldn't want to play me no more after this district. Give Coach Messina credit. He takes on all comers, and they're going to come up a little short here tonight. Once again, they meet the shotgun, not understanding this at all. And I'm going to tell you something. As Harrell runs the ball down to the 3, this is kind of tacking something on here. This can come back to haunt you later.
I tell you what, that ball was flying out a little bit. All it takes is one punch and it's gone, scoop and score. And we, I mean, it's not over.
With no timeouts left and very little time left, I think you'd be kneeling on the football here. But I guess that's why we're commentators and not coaches. Harrell on the handoff, right up the middle, stacked up.
Now you have somebody down on the field here.
During the injury timeout, there was a flag for a personal foul and sportsmanlike conduct against the Warriors, backs them up 15, and now they will kneel on the ball, but you had an injury down. And really, that is one of the reasons you should have knelt on the ball earlier. You don't want to lose a player. Could have got a player kicked out there, you know.
So many things can happen, especially in a close ball game like this. And all these kids have been fighting so hard, and frustrations are in the air. I mean, it's not a good mix.
So nevertheless, they kneel on the football. I think they'll have to do it one more time, and that will take us to the end of the game. Or will they have to kneel it? It's fourth down. You know, without
a clock, yeah, exactly.
Without a clock, it's hard to know what's going on down there.
And that'll be it.
So it takes us to the end of the game. Your final score for the Warriors, the S&S Sports Center Player of the Game. This has been our broadcast of the WSTY Game of the Week. For our cameraman, Butch Lee, my partner in crime, Rusty Berry, I'm the Big Dog Sam. We'll see you next week.
If you want our lowest prices on our best selection of new and used vehicles, then visit the Bill Hood family of dealerships, Louisiana's low price leader, or click hoodauto.com. Visit Bill Hood Ford Lincoln in Hammond, Bill Hood Nissan, Mazda, and Hyundai on the import corner in Hammond, Bill Hood Chevrolet Buick GMC in Amite, Bill Hood Chevrolet in Covington, plus our two new stores, Bill Hood Premium Pre-Owned in Hammond and Bill Hood Pre-Owned Outlet in Ponchatoula. Click hoodauto.com.
Hi, I'm Tim Bailey, and I'm running for state representative here in District 73. I plan to enhance our vocational education system so that we have job-ready graduates. I also plan to create an economic development plan for our region. South Tenshbohoe Parish is in need of a bridge of representation. I'm asking for your vote on October 24th, and allow me to be that bridge for you.
For all of your insurance needs, call State Farm agent Robbie Lee. Whether you own a house or condominium or live in rental property, State Farm has a policy that is right for you. We offer a wide variety of life insurance, health and disability insurance, as well as business insurance.
Hi, I'm Robbie Lee. For all your insurance needs, stop by 227 Northwest Central Avenue in Amite. We'll take care of you.
Robbie Lee and his friendly staff will gladly assist you. Call them today at 985-748-9000. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
When you need a pharmacy, Drive-In Drugstore has just what the doctor ordered. Located at 228 South 1st Street in Amite, Drive-In Drugstore is ready to give you the personal attention and customer service you deserve. We fill all of your prescription needs promptly and carefully, and we're happy to answer questions or concerns you may have about a particular medication. We also stock an extensive selection of over-the-counter medications, vitamins, and herbal supplements for your health and well-being. We're open Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. until 6 p.m., and on Saturdays from 8 to 2. We accept most prescription insurance plans and Medicare drug discount programs. Drive-In Drugstore in Amite.
When you want it done right the first time, take it to Jim's Paint and Body Shop. With over 30 years of automotive body repair and painting experience, Jim's works on all makes and models. Jim's is family-owned and operated. All work is guaranteed, estimates are free, and all insurance claims are welcome. Go by 55461 East Durbin Road in Independence, or give them a call at 878-2329. That's Jim's Paint and Body Shop. We do it right the first time.
Come to Buddy's Home Furnishings at 706 West Oak Street in Amite for all your home furnishing needs, including electronics, home furniture, appliances, computers, and more. Buddy's has competitive prices, big names like Ashley, LG, Samsung, Kenmore, and many more. We offer rent-to-own or 2, 4, or 6 months same-as-cash with no credit checks, and same-day delivery is available. Buddy's makes it quick and easy for you. Own it faster for less at Buddy's Home Furnishings in Amite and Hammond.
Injured on the field, hurt on the job, been in a car accident? The doctors at Anton's Chiropractic Care will help you get back to pre-injury performance level. With treatments including chiropractic adjustments, physical therapy, and massage therapy, you will quickly begin seeing results. Anton's even schedules Saturday appointments to ensure that your treatment will not interfere with your schedule. So give them a call at 985-542-1640 to schedule your appointment or stop by their downtown location in Hammond across from the Columbia Theater. That's Anton's Chiropractic Care for all your chiropractic needs.
Robbie Miller loves Tanchpo Parish. Whether you have lived here your whole life or just moved here, Robbie is committed to you. It's time for Tanchpo to play the next play. Please vote October 24th, Robbie Miller for our parish president. New innovative leadership for the future of Tanchpo Parish.
Dixie RV Superstore is your number one source for the largest selection of new and pre-owned RVs. You're sure to find the RV of your dreams with 68 acres of motorhomes, travel trailers, fifth wheels, and toy haulers. We also have an RV collision center and 56 service bays to better serve you. Dixie RV, located off I-12 exit 35 in Hammond. Check out DixieRV.com.